Hello, I'm Kipp Lau, a safety and airmanship contributor for Aviation International News. In addition to writing for AIN, I'm a captain and line check airman on an Airbus A300 for a large Part 121 airline. I recently visited Aviation Performance Solutions in Mesa, Arizona. APS specializes in upset prevention and recovery training programs, or as it's called, UPRT. Over the past 27 years, APS has trained thousands of pilots. UPRT provides pilots with the training and tools necessary to combat a loss of control in-flight encounter. Loss of control events have killed more people than any other type of aircraft accident. The loss of control threat persists on any flight at any time, and pilots only have a few seconds to recognize the situation and initiate the proper flight control inputs to safely recover from an aircraft upset. The FAA first mandated UPRT programs for all Part 121 airline pilots in 2019. This training is now largely simulator-based. Currently, there are no requirements for pilots flying non-airline operations such as business aircraft and charter to complete a UPRT program. The greatest limitation of a simulator-only UPRT program is the simulator itself. While these simulators are certified for extended envelope training into the stall regime, they cannot replicate the psychophysiological effects such as startle factor or G-awareness, and it is not possible to demonstrate flight in an all-attitude environment, either physiologically or aerodynamically. The only way to train for that effectively and safely is in a real aircraft that is capable of all-attitude maneuvering taught by a highly qualified instructor. During my three-day visit, I was able to experience just about everything that APS offers. Solid academic training.
Next thing you know, the stall horn goes off or the stick shader goes off.
On aircraft training in the Extra 300 and Marchetti S211 jet, and training in VizAv appropriate simulators, both the Citation Jet and Challenger.
See the nose is dropping? It has to.
On day one, following a morning of academics and the first mission briefing, I received safety briefings on the Extra 300 that provided an overview of the aircraft, its safety features, and emergency procedures that included training on using a parachute and egressing from the aircraft in flight. The Extra 300 is an excellent trainer for all attitude upset recovery training. It has nearly full span ailerons and a snappy roll rate of 400 degrees per second. The bubble canopy provides amazing visibility, which is useful when determining which end of the aircraft is up during an upset. My instructor was Clarke Otter McNeace. He's a former Navy F-18 fighter pilot, and prior to teaching at APS, spent some time at the airlines. According to McNeace, the objective is to become upset, stall, and spin avoidance experts. Once airborne, all the lessons from the academic sessions come to life. After some maneuvering to become reacquainted with the extra, we began a flight profile that included a full aerodynamic stall that included the four characteristics of a stall, which includes buffeting, a lack of pitch authority, a lack of roll control, and the inability to arrest the rate of descent.
I have control.
Okay, your aircraft.
You see the nose bobbing up and down?
That's the elevator thing.
Yeah, that's classic stall indication. Yep. Now let me show you something. Now look at my nose at that face full of dirt.
Yeah,
look at the airspeed increasing.
Yep.
We're above the stall speed, aren't we?
Yeah,
we're still stalling.
Then a demonstration and practice on how to properly unload or load the aircraft. This is the most critical step after recognizing and confirming the situation in any upset recovery is to manage the aircraft's angle of attack. This is the push part of the recovery. APS trains students to consistently achieve a light in the seat feeling of less than one vertical G with a target of 0.25 to 0.5 vertical Gs.
Hold it right there, get ready to push. Ready. Now smooth push. Now roll to the left. There you go, roll to the right, keep it unloaded. Now you can pull out of the dive.
Okay.
There you go, you did it. I have control.
Okay, your aircraft.
Woohoo! That's pretty cool, isn't it?
Yeah, that's awesome.
In my opinion, this is one of the greatest benefits of on-aircraft UPRT. Without this training, the pilot is not properly calibrated to effectively unload the aircraft. You can't do this in the simulator. Then, accelerated stalls to demonstrate the effects of increased load factor.
As soon as you feel that stall, upset, push, roll, power stable.
Upset, push,
roll,
power.
Stabilize. Bring the nose on up. Better, right there. Perfect.
There you go.
and then cross-controlled stalls, both slipping and skidding, with an emphasis on avoidance. These stalls, in particular, a skidding stall, are extremely nasty and are deadly at lower altitudes, such as in the traffic pattern.
There's the stall. Push. Look at that view.
Yep.
Roll. Power. And stabilize.
Wow.
Next, we flew a series of upsets, such as simulated wake turbulence encounters, nose-high upsets, nose-low upsets, and finally, a series of aerobatic maneuvers to become more comfortable and confident in all attitude flight regimes. Throughout these maneuvers, the student practices and becomes proficient utilizing APS's all-attitude upset recovery strategy. In its basic form, each step is methodical, and the pilot must announce push, roll, power, stabilize.
All right, here we are. Face full of blue, bleeding airspeed, altimeter's yeah. climbing away, not looking good. I'm going to recover.
Okay.
Push, okay. Roll, thrust.
Yep. That's half G.
That's half a G.
Yep.
Get the nose below the horizon a little bit.
Okay.
Wait for airspeed to build. Now stabilize.
Awesome.
In summary, the flights in the extra provide the typical biz av and airline pilot with solid exposure to a real aircraft upset that includes the psychophysiological effects such as startle, surprise, and fear, G-awareness, and all-attitude maneuvering. Stuff that most pilots will never have the opportunity to experience in a real aircraft.
That's How was your flight?
Oh, it was fun.
Good.
Got wet.
Really? Did it rain over there?
Otter made it rain in the airplane.
Otter! No way!
Yeah.